Welcome. I'm Arshan, and today I'll be doing the critical analysis of the destination image for Rome, Italy. The purpose of this assignment is to identify how different media portray a single destination in various ways to appeal to different types of customers. A destination image. What is a destination image? Let's take a look at what destination image is. A destination image is the gathered beliefs, ideas, and impressions of an individual that holds towards a destination or a place or a setting which is shaped by or which can be affected by the word of mouth, which can attract or repel customers according to how it is portrayed in the image. There are two types of destination images according to Jiang 2017, which is cognitive images and affective images. Cognitive images can be identified as a person's beliefs to a certain location, such as the quality or the uniqueness, and affective images can be identified as a person's emotion towards a certain place, like if he feels happy or sad about a certain place and how it's been portrayed. Now, let's see how the destination images are formed and affected by. Destination images are formed by reliable sources such as media, textbooks, and also advertisements, promotional campaigns, and personal experiences, such as if you've been to a place and experienced the culture, the way that destination feels towards you. You have formed an image about the destination. Lonely Planet describes Rome in Italy as a seductive and thrilling place, and as a large city which can be busy at certain times of the year, such as during the summer, especially during the summer. They even use a proverb such as, when in Rome, do as the Romans do. Rome concludes of many historic sites, which shows how powerful the city was in history. For example, the Colosseum, the Pantheon, and also the Vatican City, which is the main headquarters of the world's most prominent religion, which is Christianity. Lonely Planet identifies the cost per day to spend in Rome is between 100 and 250 euros, which they classify 100 euros as being cheap and 200 euros as being luxury. Italy Guides. Rome, Italy Travel Guide, which is the official Italian tourist website, classifies Rome as a majestic and beautiful city, which can be confusing for the first time visitors. They also shows or explains how the city can be a bit overcrowded during summer due to the over tourism. They also say that the city, they also show in their pictures on their website, show how the city is packed with people and vehicles, which also leads to a conclusion that it is dirty because of so much people in such as concentrated in a small area. There is a places for everybody. Like if you are into the nightlife, there is a certain area of the city which is open till late or very early mornings. If you are into like a fine good food for small coffee, looking at a beautiful old building, there are places for that too. So we can say that the city of Rome caters for almost all types of tourists. And Italy guides also focus on or encourages the tourists to use public transport whenever or at all the times possible, because it'll be really hard to navigate through the city, and also they do not recommend driving or using a vehicle if it's your first time in the city. The Savvy Backpacker, which is a backpacking website for specially designed for backpackers, classifies Rome to have really good food, art and nightlife. They also compile on how the city can be overcrowded, and also address on safety issues such as security, and outlines how there have been incidents of pickpocketing and bad restaurants in the area which are just trying to attract tourists, more like focused on attracting the tourists but not really focused on giving a good experience or good food. The food is relatively cheap, and they classify the average spend per day between 35 to 65 euros. In this image taken from Rome Travel Guide 2017, we can see how the sun is well lit and people are seated outside looking at this into the open road. In the buildings, we can see how the roads are paved with stone, marble, which shows the history of the city. And if you really look closely enough, we can see how the street is buzzing with people, how it is busy. In this image, which is also taken from Rome Travel Guide 2017, we can see the ruins, the ancient ruins of the city, what it used to be, the powerful city has now gone to waste with time. And in this picture also, if you look really closely, you can see how the tourists are in the picture. In this picture, which is also taken from Rome Travel Guides 2017, we can see how people have been dressed up as Romans, which can also be said as the commodification of the Roman culture. And if you look at the background, we can see how there's a lot of people at the background, mostly tourists, mostly all the people maybe between the age of 50 or and upwards. So if we made a destination profile for Romilly, we can see how it is a tourist hotspot, which has ancient architecture, art and buildings, reliable transport, busy, crowded and dirty and unsafe at times, and the price ranges between 35 to 250 euros per day. The different types of website targets different people. The Lonely Planet targets are people between the age of 30 to 45, focusing on the city's ancient values, history, art and sculpture. The official Italy website target crowds who are interested in exploring the city, food, wine and the architecture. The Savvy Backpacker shows average spend, a really low average spend, and outlines the bad elements such as pollution and security issues in the city. So in conclusion, as the pictures have portrayed, Rome is a city which has a magnificent history, value and architecture. Through this has been able to gather a certain brilliant seductive as Lonely Planet has described in the pictures. And also for budget travelers and high-end, they cater for both. And also, the pictures really show it doesn't matter which time of day or which time of the year, the city is really busy during all the time. Thank you for watching the video.